Welcome everybody to my talk, Headless Static Websites and Progressive Web Apps with Gatsby and Drupal. That's me. My name is Andrey. I'm a team lead at BIU, a freelancer and Gatsby React fan. Also have Drupal 8 Acquia certification as a backend developer. You can find me on Twitter.
You see that link?
So, why Gatsby? What's so special about it? Why do you have to combine it with Drupal? And the answer is performance. The goal of every website is conversion. Whether you are selling goods or you are showing some information, you require your user to do some action. Most of the time it's a click or some input, subscribe, whatever. And user experience in terms of performance is a really important thing.
So DoubleClick research, they found out that 53% of mobile users, they just left your website if the page load is more than 3 seconds. That's pretty impressive numbers, right?
I like this quote from Corvig developer at Facebook. He says, if the readme doesn't specify that the fastness is blazing, keep searching. Often you can find a similar library that does the same thing, but blazingly. Blazing means good. So, what is Gatsby? Gatsby is a blazing fast static site generator. It uses React under the hood, Webpack, GraphQL, modern JavaScript and CSS. It's open source, it's written on Node.js, it can fetch data from multiple data sources, and it generates a good base for progressive web apps using this mentioned plugins. Interesting fact that is a React website is actually built with Gatsby. Here's how the static architecture looks compared to a classic one.
So basically, your web server is no longer busy with talking to database, processing the data from database, building HTML and assets. Instead, it just returns static HTML files and assets right away. So it doesn't do anything with it. Therefore, your server load is basically much lower than compared to the classic architecture. Which is really good for high-load websites. So key benefit here is that the time to first byte is basically close to zero.
But how do you make
a static website a dynamic one? So you generate your content pages from your data source, in our case it's Drupal, and you can also do some personalizations by calling different kind of APIs. So, for example, if you need to customize some block based on user data, you have to authenticate user first and then request the dynamic part from API.
Gatsby uses GraphQL, data query language from Facebook. It's used to access imported data from Drupal. It can be also used as REST API sitting on top of your CMS. And there are a lot of implementations for all modern CMSs, so if you decide to replace Drupal with something else, you can still keep your front-end application and go on and change your CMS. Here's an example of GraphQL query. Here we query the links for our main application. It's pretty simple and it's a bit similar to the JSON format. But what if content changes? So we have static content which is compiled, but when the user, when the content editor updates the page, we can execute a build from Netlify, which we use to host front-end part of the application. It knows how to run a Gatsby build. It also specifies the URL, which you can just trigger this this build. So hook and notify. So you can execute the build hook automatically, for example, every 2 minutes or so, or by Drupal hook on content update, or manually. So there is a module for that. Link is below. It looks like this in Drupal backend. So we have an overview of all our builds, all the latest builds, their status, when it was finished, and the option to start manual deployment. Gatsby team recently introduced the preview feature. Unfortunately, it is paid at the moment, but it allows to. What this thing does, it basically triggers the whole website rebuild every time. So all of your content content pages will be rebuilt during this process. And Gatsby preview, what it does, it allows for partial builds. So only one content which is updated will be regenerated, and that's much faster. So this is how the whole website might look like. Sounds so pretty cool, right? But it's not all rainbows and unicorns, of course. So here's a list of problems we spotted when we developed the website with Gatsby and Drupal. So first of all, JSON API. JSON API by default it exports everything, which is a big problem for a Gatsby build. It's a lot of data which you definitely not need. So for example, rich text formats, right? You don't need rich text formats in your front-end application. And second problem with it is the links are exported in a Drupal format, which is also not what Gatsby expects. Also think about the problem with performance. Some sites with a big amount of content can build more than even 10 minutes. So that's of course a huge problem. So as a solution, you might want to disable many endpoints of JSON API using the built-in interface, just in Drupal admin. You just disable a lot of resources which you don't need. And you can also use JSON API filters, which allows you to select a particular content which you need in your front-end application. I would ideally use both of them. So they have pretty decent documentation. You can look it up. And for the second problem with URL being displayed in Drupal format, you can use URL enhancer. Basically, what it will do, it will rebuild the URL, the Drupal format URL into full URL, absolute URL. The next problem is with Gatsby source Drupal. This is an extension which gets data from Drupal into Gatsby. So it cannot fetch, this is more related to JSON API again, but it cannot fetch some resources as anonymous. So for example, menus is not available for anonymous user. You have to be authenticated to Drupal to get the menu data. As a solution, you can use keyhouse module. What it does is you can choose one particular user, give it a role or something. You can generate a token for this particular user, and you can then use it as a GET parameter or header request parameter, and then you will be authenticated to Drupal. If you use it in combination with Gatsby source Drupal version 3.8, 0.1.0 and higher. That will work because I made a contribution to this module, which allows to specify the either GET or REST parameter, so you can pass authentication header here. You can store your authentication header in your end file in your Gatsby application. This is basically secure because end file lives outside of your public directory, and only Netlify knows this key on Gatsby build stage. All right. So, well, Gatsby is I would say relatively young, so you might be missing some functionality, or you need some to write some patches or whatever. So in the meantime, I encourage you, of course, to contribute to Gatsby. And by the way, you will get a free swag from them. So they send away like things like t-shirts, baseball caps for contributions. But in the meantime, while you're waiting your pull request to be approved by Gatsby, what you can do is you can use a link module alias. This is an npm package which allows you to overwrite a contribute npm package with your forked one or Gatsby package. Another problem is web forms. We wanted preferably simple solution which will work with Drupal web forms. You also need to regenerate cross requests for your token every time your web form is displayed. As a solution, we used React JSON Schema Form component with a matching Drupal module. JSON Schema Form module accepts the form structure in JSON format, which is generated by the module. Module also takes care of cross request forgery token, so it regenerates it every time. And as well, it's taking care of web form submissions. So you just submit your form, and your web form submission is in Drupal backend. The module is still in development, so contributions are welcome, of course. Another problem is Drupal Gatsby Image Sharp in combination with Drupal Media. So Gatsby source Drupal or in combination with Gatsby Image Sharp, it can work with standard Drupal images, but not with media. Media again is returned in not in a full URL format, which is required by Gatsby. The second problem is that only default images return, so no image styles are exported by a JSON API. So as a solution, again, you can use JSON API enhancer. So to override the default export and export image URL in full URL format. Also, you can add as many styles as you want, so already processed images, cropped, or whatever your image effect might be. Redirects. Obviously, Drupal redirects will not work in Gatsby, as this is a separate application. Again, problem that your URLs are returned in Drupal format. As a solution, we can again implement an enhancer for returning URL alias instead of internal Drupal format. And you can also create a redirect on Gatsby build step. So here's an example of implementation. We select this GraphQL, we select all the redirects, we select the source and the target redirect. And we use Gatsby API create redirect to create it actually in Gatsby.
what this thing does, basically, it generates a folder with the name of your target redirect, and it puts a single file, index.html, in it, with a single line defining the redirect itself.
That's it. That's simple. So I would like to show you the demo.
This is a website for Dutch Hospital Association. Still a bit in development, but you can already see
that it's
pretty fast. Here's an example of Gatsby image sharp. So you see that first the image is loaded blurred. It's basically very small image, like 20 pixels or so, and it's stretched to actual size of the picture. That's why it's blurred. And when the image is ready, it automatically replaces with a real one. What it also does in terms of performance, so if I go to the network tab and I start scrolling down, it will start prefetching, you see prefetch request appearing. So it prefetches the link, it tells the browser to prefetch every link that is currently in the viewport. So basically when you click the link, it's already prefetched, it's already loaded, and it's pretty fast. Go to any link, you see that navigation is pretty instant. We also have written list functionality, so it works also instant. If you add things to the written list, it's already there. And if I go to the written list, you see the articles from the written list. Also, the deleting works instant. Same as filtering, so it's all instant. The only thing you see that images are being replaced with the real ones. So first the blurred image is loaded, and then the real one when it's saved.
We also have search in here, which works pretty. It's pretty fast with live autocomplete. So if I type anything, then you see results are filtered right away. So it's pretty fast.
Is this search provided by Gatsby?
This search is provided by Reactive Search component. It's using Elasticsearch, and it's sitting on third party. So it's not hosted by Netlify, it's third party. So every time I type in the letter, request is sent to this Elasticsearch instance, and the data is fetched. But you can see that it's already fast. Also, it's a separate one. Also have GraphQL Explorer. What it allows you to do is it allows you to see which data is available in Gatsby from Drupal as autocomplete. So if I go
like this. It shows me all the fields which it has
for this particular entity.
So I can do a query. Add some more. Do a query. So there. So you can, that's pretty nice to explore which data you really have in Gatsby application. And regarding the code structure, so here what we have yeah, cache is not really important. Of course, it should be all this excluded from our repository. This is internal Gatsby cache. Story group and VS Code is not really relevant for this project. My modules folder is basically a similar folder like a vendor with what we have in Drupal. So it's also being filled by well, comparable similar composer. It's you run npm install and you have your vendor modules all put into this folder. So this folder is also not pushed to the repo. We have plugins for altering Gatsby behavior, and the main folder is the source folder where all your components live. Here's a bit of an example of how a component might look like. So we have a GraphQL query. Here we get all the filter options for overview list. So in Drupal, it's stored as taxonomies. We just select here the list of options and we pass it to a component to render.
How long is the build time
for this website? For this website, it's around 1 minute. So it's not too bad. Community version of Gatsby, this is not possible. Maybe somebody will, you know, take initiative and write it for open source. But so far, this is what Gatsby offers, and that's web-based service, unfortunately. So now to progressive web apps. What is actually a progressive web app? Progressive web app is a hybrid of web-based and mobile app. It might look like a native app with a slightly reduced set of functionalities. So here's a small video for this client. Of course, it's like I mentioned, it's still in development, it's not optimized, and it doesn't have the right icons and some style for progressive web app. But you can see the idea. You browse the website, you can add it to your home screen, like this, and then it's over there. And it looks pretty much like a native app, so it doesn't have an address bar. If you provide a decent navigation through your website, this is pretty much a useful app. So of course, this is this might be not a good use case for just a content website, but if you imagine some service, that would be a much better example. On the right, you can see useful links. These links can help you to get an idea of what you can do with progressive web app and which features are available. So
here I have, on the left, I have a screenshot of my mobile browser, so you can see that iOS doesn't allow you to access your contacts, your SMSs, stuff like that. And on the right, you see a particular feature, or in this case, vibration, that is pretty much perfectly supportable by Chrome, but it's not, unfortunately, supported by Safari. So where to start with a progressive web app? First, you should create a manifest file. Then you should implement service worker. Make sure you have all the icons for mobile resolutions which you would like to support. You can also add fancy features like splash screen. So when your app is loading, you can add a nice splash screen with background or logo of the application like this. And the thing which I'm mostly excited about is now you can actually convert your progressive web app to a package which you can publish for Google, Windows, or Apple Store. Yeah, this is also a process of publishing. It's not really straightforward, especially for iOS. But this is pretty much should be possible. So here's an example of your manifest file. It's a pretty simple one. It defines some colors of your app, some icons. What's interesting here is display property. So when it's set to standalone, your app will be displayed without address bar. And it will give this native app feeling to your app. But what is Service Worker? Service Worker is a piece of JS that runs in a separate thread. It can be used as a background heavy lifter. So for example, tasks like syncing, where you don't need the result of your execution right away. It's event-based. It has a couple of events. It requires HTTPS to be running. It doesn't have access, direct access to window arrival or your DOM, and can communicate with window via post message methods. The link below shows some basic implementations of service workers. So here's an example of service worker, which basically allows of improves offline experience. So when you have an app, you can prefetch all the data and then serve it from cache. So here what we have service worker is listening to two events, install and fetch. So on install, we fetch a couple of assets, we store them in cache, and on fetch event you can overwrite actually what browser gets when it requests something. So when it requests a particular asset, you can say, okay, serve this asset from cache if it's there. And also, of course, you don't want to always be serving the stale data. So once it's responded to this cache, in the background, it tries to refresh to update the asset to serve the actual asset next time. Another option to start with service workers is to use Workbox. Workbox is an open source library of bulletproof implementations of most use cases for service workers. It's implemented by Google and other contributors. So we can rewrite our previous example with just two lines of code. Nice, right? And it has implementations for most offline caching strategies. It's also pretty customizable, so you can pass parameters to it. So you can. It also has a pretty decent documentation, so you can play with it and see for yourself. And a quick recap: Gatsby is blazing fast. It's basically a React app powered by static pages, and also some optimizations to make it even faster, like link prefetching, sharp images loading, that kind of stuff. We all know Drupal, that it's very nice to work with content. Progressive web app techniques help you to improve mobile user experience, and in combination, all these techniques, I believe you can create truly fascinating apps. I encourage you to try it, see for yourself, and well, I had a lot of fun working with these techniques. Thank you. Yeah, basically it can the performance can be comparable, of course, but still your web server is busy with finding that cache. You know, it's still taking requests, it's still processing, it looks looking up the root, and it basically returns your cache. Then with static website, you just spill out the ready HTML. That's it. As well as if you think about rebuilding the cache, it also takes some server processing time. And for Gatsby, it's basically, you know, unless the build is finished, you have your previous version of the website already in there in place, so it's not affecting performance anyhow.
Right. I have one more question. I was wondering during development, is Gatsby.
Yeah, yeah. There's two options. So you have Gatsby two commands. You have Gatsby develop and Gatsby build. So Gatsby develop, it will spin up the environment, and once you're editing your components, it's reflected right away. And Gatsby build is meant for production build, so it's all minified already. You can also try it on your local machine, so you can do Gatsby build and then Gatsby serve just to see it on your browser. And with develop, you can also, if you need HTTPS option, so you can just specify -- HTTPS and then it will be served via HTTPS.
Thanks. So if you're using a progressive web app, can you prefetch different parts of the site for your browser clips, I guess, or not?
I don't mean cache.
For instance, you have a set of news content and you want to prefetch the 30 top news, news items. So when you go offline, you can view them without interrupting the site.
Yeah, definitely. You can do it with Service Worker. Although you have to be careful with what you cache, because you know cache storage is also it has some limitations. So you don't want to store like if you have a pretty big website, you don't want to store everything in there. It's basically every request. So you can respond with. Custom response to any browser request, whether it's image or asset or, like you said, a query to get the news, latest news. Yeah. No, there's no need for Drupal. Basically, on Gatsby build stage, you get all of your images from Drupal. You generate, Gatsby generates like small images, which will be stretched and shown blurry, and also original images are stored in your public folder. So it's all there.
Right, thank you.
So if Drupal, for some reason, you know, it's not responsible, then you don't need it. Your front-end application is still working. Thank you.